Today, we're going to create an avatar that looks and moves like me. We begin by smiling into the camera. I love to smile. Smiling's my favorite.
And breathing gently for a short second.
Is this what breathing looks like? I'm Joanna Stern, and I'm excited to host this video.
No, I am the real Joanna.
Okay, so I clone myself, kinda.
Howdy.
Why? Well, the latest AI tools that generate text and images already make it hard to tell the difference between what's real and what's fake. What's coming next with AI-generated voice and video is gonna blur the lines even more.
So I came up with a challenge. Can I replace myself with AI for the day?
Yes, I came up with four challenges to see if AI me could sub in for real me. So real me had more time for me things. Or at least that's how I wanted it to go.
Still a little creeped out that I'm looking at frozen Joanna.
Okay, let's do this.
Before we get into the challenges, let's talk about my AI avatar, which was made by a startup called Synthesia.
I want to make my avatar.
At a professional studio in New York, the company recorded me doing a series of head movements.
I feel like I'm at the eye doctor. Okay.
And reading through a rather odd pre-written script.
Positive thinking will help you believe in yourself and fill you with self-esteem and confidence.
After that, I headed to an audio studio where I recorded another script for about an hour.
My name is Joanna Stern, and I hereby consent to this audio recording to create a custom voice.
The company took that all and used it as training data and ran it through their AI neural networks.
Hello, Joanna. You don't mind if I call you Joanna, do you?
Okay, so the voice isn't the best. A tool called 11 Labs produced something better after my producer Kenny uploaded 2 hours of my previous recordings.
I am the real Joanna.
I am the real Joanna.
I am the real Joanna.
Both Synthesia and 11 Labs work similarly. Type in anything and AI Joanna just says it right back.
Synthesia is aimed at companies that want to make internal videos. It charges at least $1,000 to create a custom avatar.
Creating a voice clone with 11 Labs is $5 a month.
Challenge 1, phone calls.
I happened to have a call scheduled that day with Evan Spiegel, the CEO of Snap. The company recently released My AI, a chatbot within the popular app.
Hey, Evan, it's Joanna. Do you worry that if we chat with AI all day, we'll stop talking to our real friends?
Definitely not what we've been seeing. I think that's one of the real benefits of our sort of testing and learning approach here. So far, I think if anything, it's going to become a conversation enhancement and improve the way that people communicate with their friends and family.
Did you think by any chance that my question to you was generated by an AI voice?
No. I mean, the first word or two was a little bit of a giveaway, but I thought maybe you were extra serious today.
Even my own sister was pretty fooled when I called her about her dead fish.
Hello?
Hey, Jules. I just heard about Swimmy Dimmy and I wanted to let you know how sorry I am for your loss.
Did you think it was me?
At first, yes, and then no. Like, it sounds obviously exactly like you, but just with the fact that, like, it doesn't pause for talking back.
Challenge 1. Pass. Challenge 2. Create a TikTok.
I asked ChatGPT to write a TikTok script in the voice of Joanna Stern about an obscure iOS 16 tip. The hardest thing was getting ChatGPT to write the truth. It just made stuff up. Finally, I got a good one, although the writing certainly was not very me. I pasted the script into Synthesia, put a green screen behind my avatar, and exported it. While the WSJ TikTok team edited, I was pretty impressed with the final TikTok.
TikTok fam, it's Joanna Stern, your iOS wizard. Today, we're unearthing the hidden world of back tap gestures.
Love that I did not have to shoot this. I did not have to put on nice clothes, do my hair, do my makeup, say these lines.
But TikTok was less impressed. They picked up on the fact that the avatar never moves its arms, that the mouth movements don't always match the audio, and that there's little facial expression. Synthesia has already started to improve a lot of this in beta versions of its avatars.
Look, I can nod my head.
Challenge 2, fail. Challenge 3, bank biometrics.
Instead of asking security questions, some banks use your voice to confirm it's you before transferring you to a customer service rep.
This call will be monitored and recorded, and your voice may be used for verification. Please speak your first and last name, followed by your mailing address.
Joanna Stern.
This is Nikki with Chase Credit Card Services.
It worked. Chase confirmed the voice and put me straight through to a service rep. No additional questions asked. Later in the day, I asked our intern Slav to try to do his best impression of me to see what would happen.
Please speak your first and last name, followed by your mailing address.
Joanna Stern.
Please enter the last three digits printed on the signature panel on the back of your card.
See, in Slav's case, the voice biometric system didn't buy it. It asked for further verification.
When I reached out to Chase, a spokeswoman said, "We use voice biometrics, along with a variety of other methods, to authenticate customers who call us." She added that to complete requests, customers must provide additional information. Challenge 3, pass. Challenge 4, video calls.
I asked ChatGPT to generate some generic meeting phrases and exported videos of my avatar saying them. Then I installed some software on my Mac to pump that video into my Google Meet calls.
It sounds good.
Oh, you're muted, Joanna.
Oh my God, is this the real Joanna?
Yeah, this looks like a fake.
It sounds good.
She looks, yeah. What is happening here?
Hey, everyone. How did you know that it wasn't me?
It looks like a hologram version of you.
It was the poster for me.
Okay.
She also didn't make any jokes.
Challenge 4, big fail.
So, what did we learn today?
We learned that video clones aren't going to fool anyone yet, but AI voices are quite good.
We also learned that while you could use these to save time, people could also misuse them. Do I want to avoid going to the studio some days? Yup. Do I fear scammers using our voices to call banks or our families? Yup. Synthesia says it requires those creating avatars to give verbal consent. 11 Labs requires you check a box saying you have permission to use the voice. And the company says it's capable of identifying its voices if they are misused. Either way, it means we're all going to have to be on high alert to tell the real versus the AI.
And finally, stay human, everyone.
Good luck. I am inevitable.